Hi everyone, this video will show you how to record with the Anchor app remotely. Now with Anchor, you have to invite a friend to record with you in order to record remotely. And this invite can be sent in two ways that I know of, via text message and via WhatsApp. Before you send out the invite though, first make sure that both people have downloaded the Anchor app onto their phone. As you can see here from this screenshot, you can download the app on the Apple Store and on Google Play. Now, a word of advice. From personal experience, I find that things like recording, whether that's podcasting or making a video, is best done when you're not using your Wi-Fi to do a lot of things. So if you have Netflix on and you're also listening to music on Spotify and you're trying to create content, things are going to be slower and wonkier, and you risk losing your work. So don't try to multitask with this one. So let's start off with how to send your invite via SMS or via text message. Watch this video here. As you can see, I'm opening my Anchor app, and then I'm clicking on invite friends to join. It's going to prompt you again to invite friends, and then you want to click messages. Type in the name of the person you're sending the invite to, and then they'll receive it. If you're on the receiving end, this is how you accept your invite via SMS or via text. Here I am in my text messages with Anne, and I'm simply going to click on the link that she sent me. Be patient. It takes time for Anchor to connect you with the person because it's being done remotely, but then it'll give you a screen that says you're about to record with friends. You may find yourself having to do this process a couple of times if your internet connection is weak. But when you're connected, you're connected, and then you can tell that you're recording with two people or more. And then when you're done recording, you just hit the X where it says finish recording. If you realize you have to record more, you can always send the invite again. Now, let's say you're not using text, you're using WhatsApp instead. This is how you send the invite via WhatsApp. Again, I'm in the Anchor app. I'm going to click on invite friends, and then I'm going to copy the link, go into my WhatsApp, and share the link. Watch that section again if you need to, okay? Now, when you receive the invite via WhatsApp, this is what you also need to do. Go into your WhatsApp and just click on the link. Again, it'll say you're about to record. Give it some time to process the thing, and then it'll connect you. Again, don't be shy or reluctant to keep trying this if it's not immediately connecting. After the recording, you want to hit finish recording and be patient. And I say be patient because Anchor takes a little while to process the file and add it to your account. When it's done processing, you're going to get a notification just like this. It'll say your recording is done processing. The longer your file is, or the longer your conversation is, the longer it might take to process. So again, be patient. After the recording, I and Anne recommend that you go on to Anchor and listen back to your episode, edit if you need to, and then you can publish and share your link on Padlet. Now, this is a short little video about how to trim and edit your episode. I recommend editing and trimming your episode on a larger device than your phone, unless your phone is ginormous. I like to use maybe an iPad or even my desktop. So even though you're recording on your phone, Remember, it's being attached to your account. And so therefore, you can simply go onto your account, whether that's on your desktop or your iPad, and edit the same audio file. The audio file will be on the account that sent the invite. So here I've clicked on the trim button in the lower left-hand corner, and it brings up this audio editing tool within the app. And then when you're done editing, it'll ask you to name that part of the file, and you just indicate afterwards that you are not ready to publish so that you can record more. And again, so I've recorded a second piece here and just added that recording to the episode. And this allows you to also rename the segments in case you want to rearrange segments and keep everything nice and organized. Now, this is how to add background music. As you can see, actually, you just click on the three dots of the segment that you want to add the background music to. And then you have the option of adding background music. I recommend listening to the music first just to make sure that it's the right tone that you're looking for before you add it. And to add it, you just click the plus sign on the right here. Now, here's how to add interludes or transitions and sound effects. I'm actually going to click over here on the pink in order to pull up the interludes. And again, they're just very short transition sounds or transition music, and you can play just to see if that's what you're looking for. You would add it to your episode with the plus button, and then again, you can drag and drop to see where in the episode you want it to be. And then you can also add some sound effects if you want to. If ever you want to see what this sounds like, you just hit preview down here, and then you can see what all of the sounds, all of the segments sound like together. Now, when you're ready to publish your episode, you've listened back, you've edited and trimmed out any parts that aren't necessary, you would hit publish. It's going to ask you if you're ready to publish. Say yes. You'll want to give it an episode title. Here I'm saying feed forward between Anne and Sarika. You can be more creative if you want to. Give a brief description of your episode. And then you want to hit done. And then publish now. You can skip the tags. And actually, I would skip the podcast creation. I can say, not right now, thanks. Not right now, thanks. Now it's been published, and then you can share the link to your episode on the Padlet. Now, when you get to the Padlet, I know some people find it a little bit wonky to use. There will be a plus sign in the lower right-hand corner here, and that's where you share the link. If the plus sign is not immediately visible, just float your cursor down here and wiggle it just to prompt the plus sign to show itself. Great. If you're having any other issues, please contact your instructor well before you are supposed to record and well before the due date. Thank you.